Member for New Westminster.
Yesterday was World Press Freedom Day, and I joined with others at the Vancouver Art Gallery to mark this important day. The theme was the right to report freely and safely, something that British Columbians take for granted, but people in many other countries do not. So far this year, 24 journalists have been killed and 158 have been imprisoned for no crime except being journalists, for telling stories that certain regimes don't want told, for taking photos that some don't want the world to see, for shedding light where some would prefer to see darkness. World Press Freedom Day holds a particular significance for British Columbians and Canadians this year, because one of the most prominent journalists to be imprisoned is the award-winning Egyptian-Canadian journalist Mohamed Fahmy, who was a student here in BC. Mohamed and two colleagues served over 400 days in Cairo's infamous Scorpion prison and convicted in a trial that has been condemned around the world, and he is presently being retried on those same trumped-up charges. He is also in need of urgent medical care for a serious shoulder injury that became much worse as a result of his prison conditions. Yesterday, Mohamed spoke to us passionately from Cairo to this gathering, urging us to raise our voices to support not just him, but other journalists around the world. I also had the opportunity to speak to him personally, Honourable Speaker, by phone, because my husband Gary is one of his Vancouver lawyers who will be joining him in Cairo this week. He told me, and he asked me to tell this House, that there's nothing that he wants more than to be able to marry his fiancée Marwa, get on a plane to Vancouver, and start a new life here in British Columbia. But he needs to be free first, Honourable Speaker. We can all help to make that happen. I would encourage you to go to free_Fahmy on Twitter and visit his Facebook page. We can all raise our voices to support world press freedom around the world.
Thank you, Member.